Thanks for tuning in to Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. Today is going to be The Adventures of Captain Marvel. Now, this is the original Captain Marvel, who now goes by the name Shazam. Years ago, he was picked up from Fawcett Comics by DC Comics. But on the in between that time, Marvel Comics came up with their own Captain Marvel. So that's why our Captain Marvel from Fawcett is now called Shazam. It lost me for a second. Now, the new movie's out. It's called Shazam. There's also another movie out called Captain Marvel. That is a female version of Captain Marvel. That is Marvel Comics. So this is the original one put out by Fawcett Comics. This is probably one of the best movie serials you'll ever see with a superhero. It has fantastic special effects for its time. And at one time, he was the rival of Superman. Originally, the Republic wanted to use Superman in the serial. They couldn't afford it because he was tied up in cartoons at the time, so they went to his best imitator, which was Captain Marvel, also known as Shazam at this time. At the time, Shazam, Captain Marvel, outsold Superman and was published twice monthly. That's how popular he was. So I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. We're showing the first half now, and I'll be back later on. Thank you again for tuning in.
What's that, Mr. Howell?
I don't know, Billy. Let's find out. What do you make of that symbol, Malcolm?
I don't know, Howell. Does it mean anything to you, Tal Shotali?
The men of the hills are gathering. The symbol says that the white men are to be driven from the Valley of Tombs.
Lieutenant, stockade gate. Man the machine guns.
Yes, sir.
Close those gates. Take your places. Man the guns. Come on, give me a hand.
Take cover, Betty. This may be serious.
This attack.
The legend, Tuan. No white man shall desecrate the Valley of Tombs.
That is not the true legend. When there's desecration, Scorpio will erupt. See for yourself, there is no eruption.
You have spilled blood without reason. Return to your people and counsel them to await a sign from Scorpio.
Shall be as you say, Tuan. The true ledger must not be violated. But the white men must leave. There is a curse which says that any white man that enters the Valley of Doom shall die.
He's coming back.
It looks as if Tal Shatali was successful.
I hope so.
Is the attack over?
Who are they? What do they want?
We will not be attacked again. If we stop our work in the tombs and depart.
But our visas and permits are in order.
The chief warns that no permit will protect us from the curse of the scorpion if we enter the inner tomb.
The only reason I financed this expedition was to examine the contents of that tomb.
Surely you're not going to be stopped by a native curse. It's superstitious nonsense.
That's what everybody said about the curse of King Tut's tomb. But a lot of them died.
We'll handle this, Billy. We'll open the tomb at once. We strike camp in the morning and be well on our way before there is any further danger from the natives. That suit you, Tal Shatali?
I wish our danger came only from the natives.
You don't take this curse of the scorpion seriously.
Believe me, gentlemen, there is a curse of the scorpion.
Nonsense. We'll be seeing ghosts next. Let's get to work.
Will you and Carlisle get these specimens back to camp?
We'll be glad to. There's an inscription here. Can you translate it, Tal Shatali?
Yes, I can translate it. It says, "Let what reposes behind this stone remain hidden from the eyes of mankind for all time."
Why, the secret of the Scorpion Dynasty must lie beyond this wall.
Perhaps it would be wise not to learn what that secret is.
That's ridiculous.
Well, I think Mr. Tal Shatali is right. I feel as though we're robbing a grave right now.
You afraid, Billy?
Well, no, sir. I just don't want to pry into anybody's secrets. I'll go into these passages to remove that pottery for you, but I don't want any part of this.
Very well.
Billy Batson is the wisest one among us. I think I shall follow his example, if I may be excused.
Just as you like.
Mm-hmm.
been? Why, it's not a tomb at all.
What on earth is it?
Well, that's hard to say.
Why, these are lenses of a sort.
They're probably a fused quartz of some kind.
Well, if this is the dreaded secret of the Scorpion Dynasty, it seems to be quite harmless now.
The sunlight seems to have something to do with it. Why? These lenses are adjustable. Here, bring them all into focus. My name is...
All is known to me. Your name is Billy Batson. You did not pry into the secret of the Scorpion. That is why I am here.
But where did you come from?
Out of the past, my son. Down through the ages to guard the secret of the Scorpion.
You've been alive all these years?
What you call life returned to me when your friends violated the tomb of the Scorpion.
Well, they meant no harm.
Then they should have obeyed the inscription on the tomb. The harm has been done. It is your duty to see that the curse of the Scorpion is not visited upon innocent people.
My duty?
Yes. So long as the Golden Scorpion may fall into the hands of selfish men, it is the duty of Captain Marvel to protect the innocent from its evil use.
But who is Captain Marvel?
You are, my son. All that is necessary is to repeat my name, Shazam. By its repetition, you will become Captain Marvel and take on the virtues you see recorded there. The wisdom of Solomon. The strength of Hercules. The stamina of Atlas. Power of Zeus, the great courage of Achilles, and the speed of Mercury. You must never call upon this power except in the service of right. To do so would bring the Scorpion's curse upon your own head. And now, my son, repeat my name and return to the rescue of your friends.
Shazam! You all right?
Yes. It was a concussion from the explosion.
What caused it?
Why, that device there. Quick,
call the others. We've got to get Lang and Fisher up to camp. You bring the Scorpion. Take care of the scroll, Bentley.
It is set forth here that a certain arrangement of the lenses will transmute any substance placed in front of the base lens to pure gold.
That's impossible.
Sounds like rubbish to me.
Well, we can soon find out. Show us how to arrange the lenses.
Billy, bring me several stones. Place them on the ground. Step back, please.
Why, it is gold. The purest I've ever seen.
Only the sun's rays is needed to create it.
If we only knew the formula for making those lenses.
What difference does that make? We've got these.
Gentlemen, do you realize that this golden scorpion makes us the richest and most powerful group in the world?
Too rich and too powerful.
Are you suggesting that we destroy the scorpion? Think of its scientific value.
I am thinking of that.
What do you propose?
That the lenses be distributed among us. That another take the scorpion itself. And in that way, the device could never be used without the consent of all.
But what about the scroll? The scorpion is useless without it.
I suggest that Billy Batson be entrusted with the scroll.
Oh, but he's so young, Howe. And this is of such vast importance.
Nevertheless, Billy is probably the only one among us who can't translate it.
Oh, but Mr. Howell, I would...
I think Mr. Howell's plan is excellent. Dr. Charlie, will you disassemble the lenses, please?
Professor Fisher? Mr. Carlyle? Professor Bentley? Dr. Lang? Mr. Malcolm? And Billy, this is for you to guard. See that you guard it well. It contains a precious and a dangerous secret.
Don't worry, Talchitali. I'll guard it.
Well said, young fellow. I'm sure you will. See that your personal belongings are packed tonight. We start to load at 4 o'clock in the morning and start for the base camp at daylight.
Signal.
Thank you, sir.
There's evil in the air tonight.
Yes, sir. You know, I feel the same way.
You seem restless tonight.
For good reason.
Mm.
recites the curse of the golden scorpion does well to protect himself. Good night.
Good night.
Turn to Raman Bar.
You men of the hills know the legend.
Aye.
It is as old as the rocks about you, spewed up by Scorpio, the guardian of the Valley of Tombs. If the hands of alien whites desecrate our holy places, Scorpio will give the sign to war.
Mr. Howell's been murdered.
Howell murdered?
Yes, sir.
The sentry's been knifed, sir.
Rout out your men. Search the camp.
Yes, sir.
Where is Howell?
In our tent.
Radio the British troops at Fort Multan. Tell them we need immediate aid.
Yes, sir. On 624 calling Fort Multan. Malcolm Archaeological Expedition on 624 calling Fort Multan.
Fort Multan, come in, M.E.
We need immediate aid. We were attacked by natives this afternoon, and two of our men have been killed here tonight.
Stand by, M.E.
Yes, Sergeant?
Trouble with that Malcolm expedition in the Valley of Tombs, sir. They're standing by.
Ask their exact position and tell them I'll send a troop immediately.
Orderly!
Must have your exact location.
Batson says the troops are well on their way.
Thank you, Billy.
One of my men reports movement in the rocks, sir.
Tell them to keep a sharp lookout, Lieutenant. Honestly believe that the volcano has anything to do with the scorpion?
That's the legend. The natives were regarded as a sign of war.
I don't believe there's a native within 10 miles of here.
Kale and ambush them.
The gorge. Send men ahead of them and dynamite the bridge. You'll have to hurry.
Thank you.
Why, it's Billy and Betty with Whitey.
Well, how on earth did you three ever...
I'll tell you about that later, Mr. Malcolm. We better get away from here.
Yes, we'll head for Fort Moulton. You can rest there, Betty.
I don't want to rest till I get back to the United States.
And boy, when we get there, well, I have a story to broadcast. The expedition reached the ship without further difficulty. All the scientists are enthusiastic over their discoveries, and they're very thankful to be back in this country again, out of reach of the scorpion.
The discovery he's referring to concerns the five lenses that fit into the golden scorpion you see before you. With the lenses in place, the sun's rays can be utilized to change inert material into powerful explosives and to turn base metals into gold. Whoever controls this device will have power such as men have dreamed of since the beginning of time.
And it's my job to get the lenses. All right, tell me who's got them and I'll get to work.
It won't be so easy, Barnett. The lenses were divided among the scientists who have hidden them carefully.
But you're one of these men. That's going to help us.
Naturally. We're holding a meeting at Malcolm's home today. I want you to see that Henry Carlyle does not arrive at that meeting. His lens is the first point of attack.
Mr. Malcolm, Mr. Carlyle has been delayed. He expects to be here in about 10 minutes.
Thank you, Betty.
Keep driving straight ahead.
What do you want of me?
Scorpion wants your lens.
You don't think I'd ever let him get it, do you?
Yes, I think you will. Those electric eyes are throwing a beam which will knock out anyone who gets between them. And at the same time... Wait, I'll show you. Unless you change your mind, we'll give you a personal demonstration.
All right, I'll tell you. It's in a safe at my home. I don't remember the combination, but Miss Wallace has it written down. I'll phone her and...
No, you'll write her a note.
All right.
And unless you follow these instructions, the Scorpion's men will carry out their threat against me. This note is signed by Henry Carlyle.
The Scorpion?
In this country.
Then we're all in danger. We should call the police.
By all means. This is an emergency. Carlyle's life is in danger.
But do you know where Carlyle's lens is, Miss Wallace?
Yes. But I promise never to tell anyone.
You needn't tell anyone, Betty. The question is, should you get the lens and deliver it as the note instructs you to?
Or should we turn this matter over to the authorities? What do you think, Lang?
I say send the lens and save Carlyle.
Fisher?
Send Miss Wallace with the lens.
Bentley?
It's the only way.
Tell Chitali?
Send the lens.
Very well.
You have until midnight to get the lens and deliver it.
The note said you must go to the Elm Street Bridge alone. Are you willing to do that?
For Mr. Carlyle, yes.
If you'll all keep in touch with me by telephone, I'll let you know as soon as Betty reports.
Betty. I have an idea. Now, you won't need to take any chances because I'll see that everything goes all right. Okay, it's clear.
You're set, Whitey?
Sure, let's go.
We'll follow him when he leaves.
Get your hands up, both of you. All right, go ahead.
What's this?
They were watching you, Colin.
Search them.
Sam!
keep away from me, or I'll let your pal here have it.
Try to trap us, but I got away with the lens.
This box is empty. We'll have another talk with Mr. Carlisle. Come on. So, thought you'd trick us, eh?
Oh, I know. I wrote the note asking Betty to get the lens for you.
She didn't get it. You better figure out a better way to persuade her.
I don't know what else I can do.
No? Well, think and think fast. We'll help you. If you can't figure out some way to get that lens, you'll go under the knife. And we'll go after the girl ourselves.
I can't. I don't know what more I can do.
Throw him in. Throw him in.
Come on.
Billy, where have you been?
Oh, I got tied up on a special broadcast. Did anything of importance come up?
Sort of. I'm going to get Mr. Carlisle's lens from his Oak Mountain Lodge. It's in his safe. He gave me the combination.
Are you going alone?
Yes.
Why should you go?
Well, Mr. Malcolm and the others think the Scorpion is watching their movements, but feel he'd never suspect me.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that. He seems to know every move that's made around here.
But I've already said I would go.
You better take my car.
Why?
Well, it has a two-way radio in it. If anything goes wrong, you can talk directly to my office. Now, keep it tuned into that wavelength.
All right, Billy, if it'll make you feel better.
You may as well come in, Talshatali.
Is Mr. Malcolm still here?
No, he left about an hour ago.
Thank you. I'll stop by this evening.
Oh, just a minute. Why don't you try his club? You might find him there.
Hello, Whitey. Betty's leaving Malcolm's in my car. I want you to follow her.
Well, I'd be glad to, Billy. I'll be tied up here for a few minutes, though.
Well, in that case, pick her up at Elm and 4th. I'll stall her for a while.
Okay, I won't let her get out of my sight.
Okay, Whitey.
Friends think they can keep me from getting Carlisle's lens, but they do not realize the power of the Scorpion. Carlisle's lens shall soon rest here. The others will follow in turn. The dynasty of the Scorpion will live again, and I shall rule mightier than the ancient Shagatal.
Where is this lens, and how do you plan to get it?
The lens is in a safe at Oak Mountain Lodge. Malcolm's secretary has the combination, and we'll be leaving soon to get it. This is what you must do at once.
Drive up into that truck.
Thank you.
Looks like your boyfriend lost track of you. All right, hand over that combination.
I don't know what you mean.
Never mind the chatter. I want the combination of Carlisle's safe. Give me that bag. This is it.
What are you going to do with me?
Just sit tight. You'll know soon enough. I got the combination, Martin. Head into Cliffwood Road.
You can't get away with this. The police will soon know what the Acme Storage Company are using their trucks for.
Cliffwood Road. Acme Storage Company. Shazam!
I don't think the police will hear about this. That'll keep you from getting into any trouble. Tie down the wheel, we're leaving.
Shazam!
Betty! Betty!
Now, how did you get here?
Well, never mind that. We got more important things to worry about.
Those men, they got the combination to Carlisle's safe.
Oh, that's bad. Yeah, but I can get to the lodge ahead of them in my plane.
Let me go with you.
Oh, after what you've been through, you need a rest. I'll drop you off at Malcolm's on my way to the airport. I'll go get the car.
Billy's on his way to the airport now.
Gentlemen, you have heard my secretary's story. It's startling proof that we are menaced by a master criminal.
Well, that's true, but as long as Batson gets there ahead of them, we have nothing to worry about.
Surely with Carlisle's lens in our hands, a scorpion is helpless.
I wouldn't be too sure, gentlemen. Did you say Billy was taking his own plane?
Yes. Why?
Nothing. Mere curiosity.
Well, since we can't do anything till Billy returns, there's no use waiting any longer.
I agree. Gentlemen, good night.
Good night,
Miss Wallace. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
That'll be all for you tonight, Bertie.
Good night, Mr. Malcolm.
Good night.
Brandon. This is the Scorpion.
Brandon speaking.
Listen carefully. Batson is on his way to get his plane. You know about that atmospheric exploder.
Yes, I've got it right here.
Well, here's what I want you to do with it. Put it in his plane and set it for 8 o'clock with a 1-minute fuse.
Call him, please. Hello.
Hello, Whitey?
Yeah. What is it, Betty?
What? And the Scorpion has set a bomb with a 1-minute fuse to start burning at 8 o'clock. You must warn him.
Yeah, sure, Betty. Right away. I'll get right on it. Four BL calling 2RM. Four BL calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. BL calling 2RM, calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. This is 4BL calling 2RM, calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. Why doesn't that guy answer? This is 4BL calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. There's a bomb wired to explode in your plane at 1 minute past 8. Please come in, Billy Batson. Please come in. This is 4BL calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson.
Thank you.
This is 4BL calling 2RM, calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. Why doesn't that guy answer? Come in, Billy Batson. Please come in. This is 4BL calling 2RM. Please come in, Billy Batson. There's a bomb wired to explode in your plane at 1 minute past 8. Bail out! Shazam!
Good. You had no difficulty getting it, eh?
No. Everything worked out just as you had planned.
I need three more lenses to complete the solar atom smasher. When that is accomplished, I'll be able to create unlimited wealth and have a weapon which will make me invulnerable.
Getting the remaining lenses should be easy now that Billy Batson's out of the way.
But Batson isn't dead.
But he was in that plane. How could he have escaped?
I don't know. But I overheard Betty talk to him this morning. He said he was rescued by Captain Marvel. We must attend to him at once. And this time, not even Captain Marvel can save him.
I don't know how.
I can arrange it. There is to be a meeting at Malcolm's house today, and Batson will be there. Since I have the confidence of the others, it'll be simple for me to have Batson sent to any place that we may...
Afternoon, gentlemen.
Hello, Billy.
Hello, Betty.
I thought you were going to prevent the Scorpion from getting Carlisle's lens.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Fisher. I tried to.
Billy did all he could, Mr. Fisher. And you might remember that his efforts are also for your benefit.
My benefit?
Please, let's not lose our tempers.
Yes, gentlemen, we mustn't get rattled. Howell and Carlisle are both dead. And each of us can look forward to the same violent end as long as the Scorpion remains unknown and at large.
You're quite right. But the problem still remains. What are we going to do?
Destroy the remaining lenses.
And deprive the world of the most revolutionary device in history? I can never agree to that.
I'm sorry to be so late, but I believe I've made an important discovery.
The sign of the Scorpion.
Where did you get it?
At Carlisle's. I was going through his study in the hope of finding a clue and found this on the floor.
What do you make of it, Lang?
I know only one man in this country who might have such a collection. He's Chan Lal, the Oriental curio dealer.
If Chan Lal has such a collection, the Scorpion must have got this from him.
But suppose this Chan Lal is working for the Scorpion. In that case, if one of us goes to a shop to investigate, we'll only put him on his guard.
Billy could go. No one would suspect him.
Well, that's fine with me. I'll go right now.
I wanted to go downtown, Mr. Malcolm, if you don't need me anymore.
Oh, certainly, Betty. Run along.
Where are you headed for, Betty?
I got the license number of that truck the Scorpion's men were in yesterday. And I want to go down to the motor vehicle department to find out who the owner is.
Good. You get all the dope you can on it, and we'll talk it over when I get back from Chance. I wonder if that was deliberate. Wait here.
starting to wonder about him.
Me too. But we'll have to wait till we get to the bottom of these clues. Chan Lal?
Yes.
You startled me.
1,000 pardons. What can I do for you?
Do you recognize this?
Why, certainly. Where did you get it?
I found it. Who'd you sell it to?
Sell it? Never. My collection is intact. This must be an imitation.
Are you sure?
Well, to end all doubts, suppose we go down to the vault, check through the collection.
All right.
Gag him. Lock him in a vault. I'll phone Barnett.
He'll be securely guarded.
Mr. Carter?
Yes, what is it?
I understand that you rented a truck recently. License number 6W721.
Yes?
Can you tell me who rented it?
That's what I'd like to know. The truck hasn't come back yet. And the driver gave me a phony name.
Oh, I see. Well, thank you very much.
Upstairs.
Swell.
They got that Batson kid for sure this time.
He's locked up in Chanwell's vault.
What are they going to do with him?
Barnett's going down there to take care of him. I'll see if he's there now.
Someone's on the extension.
Get that car moving.
out, sister. You're not leaving just yet.
Take her upstairs. I'll get hold of the Scorpion and see what he wants to do with her.
Hello, Chan. Where's Batson?
Steph is about. Come in. Oh, you got it.
Yes?
Shazam!
No, you better take care of her there. Yeah, make it look like an accident. My men just captured the Wallace girl. Looks like a lucky day for the Scorpion.
The day isn't over yet. Wallace! Talk fast, or I'll...
All right, I'll tell you. She's at the M Street garage, near 4th Avenue.
Keep an eye on her.
Barnett says we've got to get rid of her and make it look like an accident.
Well, I've got some paint remover. I give her a whiff of that, load her in the car, and turn her loose down the ramp.
That'll do it.
Thank you.
Keep an eye on her. What do you do with her?
Barnett says we've got to get rid of her and make it look like an accident.
Well, I've got some paint remover. I give her a whiff of that, load her in the car, and turn her loose down the ramp.
That'll do it.
Scorpion's men. They're up there on the top floor.
It's Captain Marvel. That won't do any good. We've got to get out of here.
This'll fix Captain Marvel. Untie it.
Who is a scorpion? Talk or I'll...
I'll talk. I'll tell you anything. Well, let me loose.
Well, he isn't here. Who is a scorpion?
I don't know. I've never seen him.
You take your orders from him, don't you? Don't you?
Yes, but he always wears a mask.
You've heard him talk?
Yes.
You could recognize his voice, couldn't you?
I think so.
All right, I can use you. Come on.
I'm sorry about interrupting the meeting, Mr. Malcolm, but I have something very important to say to you. Every time we have a meeting, the Scorpion and his men know all our plans.
It does seem that way.
It is that way. The last time we met, Tal Chitali showed us a miniature which he said he found. Dr. Lang said it might have come from the shop of Chan Lal in Chinatown. At Chan Lal's shop, I was attacked by the Scorpion's men, and I wouldn't be here right now if Captain Marvel hadn't rescued me.
Well, all this is very disturbing, but do you think you should discuss it in the presence of an outsider?
This man happens to be one of the Scorpion's men. One of you gentlemen should know him.
Do you mean to imply that the Scorpion is here?
Yes, right here in this room. This man's only seen the Scorpion masked, but he knows his voice and he can identify it.
Young man, are you serious?
This is outrageous.
Oh, it's utterly ridiculous.
All right, Owens. You've heard them all speak now. Is one of them the Scorpion?
I don't know.
But you said you could recognize the Scorpion's voice. Don't any of them sound like him?
I can't. I thought I could, but I can't.
You've only succeeded in insulting us all, Billy, and making a fool of yourself.
I quite agree with you.
You're right, Fisher.
It's all a clumsy bluff.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Malcolm. I really thought...
Don't let it bother you, Billy. Only don't be so impulsive next time. I'll see that the whole thing is smoothed over before the next meeting.
Thanks, Mr. Malcolm. Go on, you.
What are you going to do with this man?
Since he won't tell us who the Scorpion is, there's only one thing left to do. We're going to notify the police.
Wait a minute. Don't call the cops. I'll tell you where I saw the Scorpion.
All right, I'm listening.
He has a hideout in the old Harrison mine.
Where is this mine? Can we get there today?
Sure. Back in the hills. I'll tell you where it is.
Tell me where it is. You're gonna show me where it is. I'll call you whenever I get some information.
Fast.
Is the trap working all right?
Just tested it. Can't miss.
Good. Young Batson will never know what hit him.
But what about Captain Marvel? He seems to appear every time Batson's in trouble.
Don't worry, Barnett. I also have plans for our friend, Captain Marvel. With the power of these lenses, I can turn the inside of this mountain into molten rock. No one. Not even Captain Marvel can survive that. Here's how my plan will be carried out. That's it over there.
Keep walking, Owens, and don't make any breaks. the matter?
I don't like this.
Go ahead. Shazam!
So you're the Scorpion.
You expected to find me here, didn't you?
Yes, but I don't believe you expected me.
On the contrary, I'm prepared to receive you properly.
I've waited a long time for this opportunity, and I'm going to find out who you are right now.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, but you won't learn my identity now or ever. Fairly trapped, my friend. There are several hundred feet of solid rock all around you. And if you try to escape, you'll find not solid rock, but molten rock. Focus the beam directly into the mouth of the tunnel. Thank you. directly into the mouth of the tunnel. That's the end of Captain Marvel. Now that Captain Marvel is out of our way, we should have no difficulty in getting the rest of the lenses.
It'd be a cinch if we only knew where they were.
I expect to find that out very soon. Furthermore, after the meeting this afternoon, no one will ever suspect that I was one of the Malcolm expedition when the lenses were found in the tomb of the Scorpion.
Shazam!
A message from the Scorpion. Operator, can you trace that call? The person speaking for the Scorpion hung up. It couldn't be traced.
What was the message?
He said to tune in on shortwave band 16 at 4 o'clock.
Well, it's almost that now. See if you can get that band, Whitey.
This is the Scorpion, speaking to the members of the Malcolm Scientific Expedition. I am now reporting that I have obtained all the lenses I seek but one.
Our lenses? Why, he must have robbed...
Therefore, I am warning all the members of that group to try in no way to recover the lenses or to interfere with me in obtaining the last one. It will mean death.
I can hardly believe it. The Scorpion must have stolen all those lenses from where they were hidden.
Apparently, mine was the only lens he wasn't able to get his hands at.
I suggest we each examine the places where we hid our lenses and search for clues.
A good idea. Let's start at once.
I sure wish Billy would show up.
So do I.
Boy, am I glad you got here.
Where are Mr. Malcolm and the others? I thought there was a meeting scheduled today.
Well, there was. But we had a radio message from the Scorpion saying that he had all the lenses but one.
And Mr. Fisher and Mr. Bentley rushed away to see if the Scorpion left any clues.
I don't understand it. I'm sure the Scorpion is one of this group. That must be a trick of some kind. Yeah, but I don't see why he would. I get it. The Scorpion sent that message so the men would rush right to the place their lenses were hidden.
You mean the lenses might not have been stolen?
Exactly. That was a trick to make them reveal the hiding places. Now, Whitey, we got to get moving. I'm heading for Bentley's, and you drive over to Warren Fisher. I'll meet you there later. So long, Betty.
Good afternoon, Mr. Bentley.
Good afternoon.
That lens must be here. I've got it.
Mr. Bentley! Shazam!
They got Mr. Bentley's lens.
Where's Mr. Bentley?
He went out. He didn't say where he was going.
I know he trusts you. See that he gets his lens when he returns. I've got to get to Mr. Fisher's.
Yes, sir.
What reason have you to believe it's on these premises?
It's obvious. This is the place you rushed for when you heard I had the lenses. You wished to see if I left any clues.
Show you. Watch over there for the wall panel to move. Get it.
Fisher, throw that current off. Get that lens for me. If anyone else is killed, it's going to be you.
Drop that gun!
Hi, we're back again. I hope you enjoyed that. This is the first part of The Adventures of Captain Marvel, black and white version now, and we'll be showing the second half in a later show. Make sure you tune in to Don's Breakfast Cereal, and you can also find me on Facebook underneath Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. So give it a shot, and thank you for tuning in, and join us again for our next adventure of Captain Marvel, the second part. Thank you again. Good night.